allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, kind of. Stephen, would you please take roll? Dennis Carl is excused as he's still again.
Commissioner Rogers?
Present.
Commissioner Reed?
Here.
Commissioner Whittington?
Here.
Commissioner Burkle?
Here.
Thank you. One addition that I know of to the agenda for discussion is IFT or, let's see.
Yes.
IFT for Beaverton Township, East Jordan Plastics. We'll talk about that just in a few minutes. Are there any other corrections or additions? Reading of the cash balances.
Cash balances of August 27, 2013. 101 general fund, $372,977.74. Advance from 516 UT, $655,000. Advance from 239 Gypsy Moth, $350,000. Advance from 216 E91, $725,000. Total cash, $372,977.74 before the bills.
Thank you. And as part of our consent agenda, that does include, and not limited to, but it does include the floodplain task force bill from Boyce Hydro, and I emailed Township South. There's a few questions that have been satisfied. I'm satisfied that, I guess, we pay it.
I think we should pay that.
So on with the consent agenda. It's been moved and seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. I'll give that to the treasurer. Are there any public comments at this time? No public comments. And we don't have anybody on the agenda today. No, I just emailed it out. Do you want a copy? Committee reports then.
Sage Township on the 14th, city meetings, 21st, Tantos, Pratt Lake, and Wiggins Lake Improvement Board. 24th, last Saturday, we had the Canada's Waste Collection. Went super, I hope, continue. We took it, there was over 200 cars that come in. We took over 200 tires that are not laying in ditches someplace. It went real well. And also, I give you a note from Downtown Development from the City of Gladwin. Vice Chair Joe Myers, they're looking at helping us out with a memorial out in front, you know, on a roll, I should say. It's meant in that front part because it's getting bad and it's become a trip hazard. So sometime in May, we'll take and re-cement that and make it look a lot better. We're trying to do that and we're trying to see kind of update. And then also we're looking at redoing the brick. They need to caulk. A lot of the water's getting in now and it's taking when the frost heaves some of the brick and takes some of the face off. And we're looking at painting that too. And then that's and if I mispronounce the name, I'm sorry if I do, but Carl O'Branser. He's from Billings, World War II vet. Larry Slavic, City of Beaverton,
the let's see, we start with Beaufort City and the Beaufort Fire Department to attend the open houses. And the Human Services meeting went well. I passed out the pamphlet, which I think is well done. The comments from Sheriff Shea and yourself and so forth, I think, are very revealing. And I think most people that are intellectually objective understand what we're up against. So, last night at the county government meeting, Wolhart brought the issue about the GIS contract language that he would like to have it clarified, and about a software problem apparently that exists between some of the software that Gina is using and some of the individuals. Another lady, I'm not sure what township she's from, she mentioned that the data on the Gladwin County website is not current, that there's inaccurate phone numbers, and is that under data, under data committee, or where do we?
That's right. I can just have him go through it again. We did it not too long ago, but.
And another township treasurer didn't get her name, but Linda Darlene were with me, so we tried to come up with it. He mentioned about the posting of the tax paid, said that there was some discussion about being an incompatibility between BSA and POM, but I don't think that's the issue. It's something's being changed slightly. I don't know what it is, but I think she was from Butler. She said the information isn't posted so that some of the banks and realtors and so forth can't determine if the tax has been paid. Now that's all I got out of it. So, but the Harvest Dinner is August 28th for Buckeye Township. August 28th. October 28th. Older people do that, Terry. And other than that, got a lot of stuff this week on the Board of Health, got two meetings with them, Region 7B. Things that I'll keep you up to date on and what's going on.
Very good. While we still have Christy here, did they complete your report? I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's all I do.
Beaverton Township is requesting that we approve an IFT for Jordan Plastics, and it's in the amount of $4,500. So
I'll make that motion.
Well, it's
if it's necessary.
If the board has any objections, then we would have to attend that hearing. But for the most part, they just—if you have any objections, we need to call them. We've never had any. It's just a tax break for the business. They're expanding.
I was in the meeting when he made the presentation, Josh. So, okay.
Any objection from anybody? Should we move on that, or do you need to move on?
I don't believe so. Okay. Just make a note of it in the minutes that the board's okay with it.
And I'll share that with Cheryl. She can have that.
Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner Whittington.
I attended a couple of township meetings. One of them kind of interesting was the one that Don was referring to. I mean, C-Corp. They had a lot of questions about the millage, and they were good questions. Also, they were very unhappy with the Drain Commissioner's office. And I think Colin was going to deal with it, hopefully. And they had mentioned that they were having some problems with the Road Commission quality of work. that was being done out in City Court on some of the roads with chip and seal. And I can relate to that because we've got the same thing in Billings. To me, it's a total waste of money, but that's not my decision to make. I attended a UDC meeting and I see Mr. Hall's there and UDC, I run into him all, I don't know how that man makes all those meetings, but anyway, you're doing a good job and the UDC is moving right along. So with that, we'll move on to the finance matters. We have a letter from the under sheriff, the finance committee, that he was informed that the vendor was going, that was going to supply the holsters for the tasers, can no longer acquire them. We will now have to buy them direct from Taser International. Unfortunately, buying them direct from Taser International is at a higher cost. The price per holster is now $61.95. I do have a solution to the funding issue, which will help the project continue forward. I am still requesting authorization to purchase two tasers at a cost of $3,288.62. The cost for the holsters will now be $817.43. Total cost of the project will be $4,106.05. I would ask that $1,000 be paid from the jail's canteen bucks. This is money provided by one of our jail vendors for contracting their services. I will still complete a grant request from MMRMA for $800. This will leave a balance of $2,306.05, which I would request be paid from the Securus Technology Fund. The total cost will need to be paid up front and the reimbursements will then be requested to cover the cost. If you have any questions, please feel contact me.
The sheriff is requesting authorization to allow Glavin Ford to repair a patrol car 26-7. It ended up being sustained substantial damage. They've already incurred a cost because of that. Total cost for the repairs is $2,457.71, so $2,457.71. And then we're going to run this through the insurance.
And I did find that that you did that.
Okay. Well, since I gave you the wrong minutes.
I would make a motion.
Is there support?
Support.
Moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed.
What was the balance out of the insurance?
I'm not sure how that's going to work yet. I need to figure that out. I think we have a $1,000 deductible, so we'll end up with about $1,457 back.
Okay, moving on to finance matters. The secondary road patrol grant 416 has been completed for submission to the state for 2013-2014 funding. Authorization is needed to allow the clerk to submit the grant for funding. And I would make that motion.
It's been moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Motion passes.
Item number two, Matt McCourtney, jail administrator, will be attending Corrections Leadership Training Initiative on September the 11th through the 13th and October 21st through the 23rd. The class will cost $575 with $82 per night for lodging. All costs will come from line 264 000607000. Motion needed to allow the jail administrator to attend and to make appropriation lodging registration, and I would move that we do that.
Support.
It's been moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.
Item three, Mike Brubaker, 911 director, made request for the following trainings. All training costs will be paid from line 282-000-804-001. Dispatchers Fitzpatrick and Norris to APCO training in Tustin, Michigan on September 25th through the 27th. Total cost is $550 and there is no lodging for this training. And I would move on that also.
It's been moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.
Dispatcher Tefter to Homeland Security for 911 professionals in Alpena, Michigan on September the 24th. Total cost is $175 and lodging has already been set. And I would move on that also.
Support.
It's been moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Passes. Mike Brubaker for enrollment in the Cleveland County Leadership Program. Total cost is $350 and will be paid from line 101-422-804-000. This program is held on Fridays from September to May. And I would move on that also.
I'd like to know what is it?
The leadership program is more about getting in tune with local governments and how they operate. And
this is what, about the third or fourth year of that program now?
Probably 4 years, Bob, do you remember? Four?
And over the years, we've had some good success with the leadership program.
So there's a motion and support, right? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion passes.
Item number four, Rob Fry has requested a motion of approval from the board for the installation of an antivirus software totaling $1,545 for 1 year of service. The purchase will be paid from 101-258-815-006 upon approval. And I would make that motion.
Support.
It's been moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.
Number five, Bob Fry has also requested that the county purchase a new server for the treasurer and prosecuting attorney to share space on, eliminating the need for two servers. Total cost of $5,732.60 to be shared between the two departments upon invoicing. And I would so move.
Support.
And I'll comment on that. It seems like a lot of money, but the system was just down for, I don't remember, Cheryl, you might, 2 days.
By the time we got back up.
He's taken out of his operation.
Well, they're all trying to get some monies together. The prosecutor has some and the treasurer.
Do you recall when we did the walkthrough to all of the hardware and software stuff with Bob and Sharon myself and all this? Mm-hmm. We made a list at that time, and this isn't unexpected. But we're going to have costs in this very near future on a lot of our equipment, mm-hmm. hardware, as well as software. Mm-hmm. But because it's antiquated, some of it's way out of date. So.
Josh, that's also, that server will also act as a backup if something happens to the
with the current server, yes. That's the way he wants to network it, so. There's motion and support, so all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.
Item number six. The Finance Committee would like pre-authorization to allow the clerk to make application for USDA vehicle grants if funding becomes available. A motion is needed to allow the clerk to sign necessary documents as they become available. And I would make that motion.
Support.
Supported, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.
Item seven. The undersheriff has requested permission to fill a full-time vacant position created by deployment as a temporary position with one of the current part-time employees because the undersheriff does not know when the employee will be deployed. He is asking the board to approve the temporary full-time position and the hiring of a temporary part-time position. And that seems like all complicated, but we discussed that in the finance of the, and I finally got it through money, I'd go ahead and make it, of course. And I think that deployment was the National Guard, would that correct, Ray?
Yeah, and that's anticipated sometime in November, so we could get a letter tomorrow, it could be 3 weeks from now, we don't know, so we just want to be prepared when it happens.
And I would make that motion.
Support.
It's been moved and supported, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.
And last, the undersheriff has requested the purchase of 2 taser units for the jail.
We covered that.
Yeah, we already did.
Yeah, it was just an amendment because the numbers changed, so.
So, that is the finance.
Thank you. And then under my stuff, and everybody has these pamphlets, and you can pick some up if you want. It just explains quite well where we're at, how we got here, and, you know, what we need to do. At the end of the day, there's only so much money that comes in, and state revenue sharing, as it says in here, Loudoun County lost in the neighborhood of $3 million. That makes it pretty difficult to keep up with the software programs that we need to update and the different computers and printers and fuel and cars and USDA's cutting back. And with that, we have a resolution in regards to our state revenue sharing that other counties have adopted and sent down to MAC, I believe. I forwarded that resolution to you guys a few days ago, and I would offer that resolution. We need to get a number, and I don't know what that number is going to be, Cheryl.
It's 2013-079.
Support. And this resolution technically asks for our full revenue sharing, not wagered by whatever they may or may not shake hands on at the state level. Just give us what statutorily is ours. It's 2013-019.
I brought this up at the county last night, and everybody understood. Kathy supported me on it. So
I made the motion, and was it supported?
Supported by them.
Yep, we'll call on that.
Terry Walters?
Yes.
Commissioner Reed?
Yes.
Commissioner Whittington?
Yes.
Commissioner Merkel?
Yes.
And Dennis would be excused. And some of the emails that I've been getting, I just think it's important that I share some of those. Some of them come directly to me, whether at work or my county email. I've had a couple hit our email for the county board, and those are drain issue concerns. And again, as we all know, we've sent those concerns indirectly through our attorney and then through Joel Johnson, so everybody knows that, you know, whether we're comfortable with some of these issues or not, you know, it's out of our hands, really. And I don't know what else this board can do other than make sure that we're communicating with the Joel Johnsons of the world and, you know, people at the state level. It's a very misfortune, and I just want to make sure that everybody knows we're communicating those concerns, we're passing those on. Also, there was a couple on the revenue sharing asking us to, well, some on this resolution and why we're not pushing harder, which this is one method of pushing a little harder. And then there was one on tax sale. Christy, we took care of that gentleman on the house that he wanted.
We're already satisfied, he's good.
Okay, so he's able to buy that house because the sale wasn't closed yet.
Marty, the auctioneer, didn't correspond with this gentleman. The sale was still open, so they allowed him to buy it.
Fantastic. Yep. There was a house up in Sherman Township that this individual wanted, couldn't make the sale, and then the sale was over, And there was just a big mess of communication that I had to sort through, but Christina figured it out. That's pretty much all I have. Is there anything?
I'd like to add, Mr. Balder was at the Sage Township meeting, and kind of very informative, and I think it asked a lot of, he answered a lot of the questions that the townships had, and some of the people that were there, so that worked out great. And then Joel Johnson was there too, so.
Anything else from the board?
One more thing. Bob Fry helped us out. The veterans got their new computer program set up that they've had since January. And they can do a lot of stuff online now. And it makes things a lot speedy for veterans coming in to send their forms in, send the mail in. This worked out great.
Anything else from the board?
If you may, I may just ask if Mr. Balder would like to make a statement or...
Okay. EDC-wise, things are going well. I did send letters in follow-up to the invoices that were sent out to the townships, explaining all of what EDC has done and is doing, and that's helped clarify a lot of things. I've been on a mission to visit all of the townships. I think I've visited with six of them maybe at this point. And it's gone really, really well. It's been very well received. I've only had one response from a township at this point saying we're not contributing towards the EDC. So really it's been great. We're in the process of updating our website, and when we get all done, it should be the latest and greatest. We're going to have hopefully a new logo, so that will be very well received. We're going to change our URL name. Right now we're www.gladwincountymeansbusiness.org, and that's long and cumbersome, so we're going to change that hopefully. And so I guess that's it, but it's going really, really well. So
some of the jobs that's taking place a little bit?
There's jobs open all the time, and I can't even keep count of them anymore. We've probably got 15 job postings on our boards, and every day we're posting new jobs. Part of the problem is our wages just aren't that high. Our wages are $8 to $12 an hour, where sometimes you go to Grand Rapids and other areas and you're looking at $18 to $20 an hour. So that's been a little bit tough, but we are putting people to work. We're doing a lot of employment contracts, and so I think the businesses are real happy with what we're doing at Michigan Works and Gladwin County EDC. But people are going back to work, so it's good.
Anything else? Anything from the public? Sure.
Maybe it comes under your next business that comes before the board, so I don't want to jump the gun, but I promised the finance committee a little chart on a potential savings on an employee. I thought I would give it to you at least for consideration. I don't necessarily, but I'll walk you through it real quickly. Couple of things we've discussed a couple of times in the past, you know, cutbacks and savings and that kind of thing, and that's the motivation behind this. Along the top yellow, you'll see the potential cost savings for Gladwin County for the next 3 years. I want to take you back for a second. When we voted in the 911 millage and had the public support that millage, it was important to them and to us that we remain fiscally responsible when it comes to 911. Very important. And we said that we were going to hold those costs at what they voted in at least for a 10-year period. So the 3 years is the last 3 years of this 10-year millage that we've had out there. Fair enough? Just give me a holler. Our point is, and Ray and I and Mike Brubaker over there, we actually looked at some of the dollars and cents here, working with the clerk's office and that kind of thing. Our hopes are, with this potential savings, is that we can continue that same millage out for the next 5 years, when this next 3 year goes, without any kind of an increase. That's the motivation behind it. So, in any event, it comes with a couple of caveats. Of course, 911 assistant wages you'll see in the top left, that $111,000, that's a 3 years total wages. Now, even if you follow that across, the fringe package on that, what you'll, is the 73, and then you'll see the 185 there off to the right. That's what it costs to have that particular individual employed at the sheriff's, or I'm sorry, at 911 over the next 3 year period. That would be 2014, 2015, and 2016. In any event, there was an insurance buyout option or potential that another county employee had for their spouse. And you can read most of the rest of that down there. But what you'll find is a single subscriber versus a double subscriber in the event that she retires. You're looking at about $3,900 versus $9,000. What would the county be on the hook for? And I'll break this all down for you a little more in a minute. County would be on the hook for a 9 month period for about $5,461. So it gives you some kind of an idea there. One of the things that we got administratively at the sheriff's office is I don't know that I can get by without this person entirely. That's what brings it down to there. What I need to have back out of that budget is about $6,000 a year. That's an estimate. I don't know what it'll be. You just heard some training earlier on in this meeting. That's what that individual does, is cover those trainings. When there's an employee off, this particular assistant administrator covered those gaps while those employees were off, saved us a ton of time because they would just manipulate their schedule and fall into those things. You'll see that $6,000 per year by 3 years, of course, is $18,000. So your buyout option, if you will, is about $23,000. Well, if you compare that against the $185,000 that it's going to take to keep this person employed over the next 3 years, just take a quick look at that. Your potential savings for the county is $161,663 over the next 3 years. That's a 3 year combined total. So, two questions for the board, and they don't necessarily have to be answered now, but I wanted to give you this chart and give an explanation because I can't get any more than two of you in a room at a time. The potential for savings, like I said, is $161,000. You entered into some kind of an agreement with a supervisory group that we wouldn't promote anybody into that group about a year or 2 years ago, somewhere in that neighborhood. So we would have to work around that however you saw fit. And the reason being is because I do need to have somebody in a supervisory role. I would be operating with one person less, but I still need to have that middle line supervision for quality control. There's a variety of things, FOIA requests, and the list goes on and on. I need to have somebody do that. Well, that only costs you $1,700 annually to have somebody do what they're doing now for that advancement. So those are the two issues. Primarily, it's a $1,700
well, part
stipend.
Of, you was splitting the shifts, so
yeah.
One's day, one's night, or however you work that.
Yeah, we're going to move some things around. Potentially, they could overlap. We wrote a $300,000 grant for 911 instead of having Gladwin County taxpayers paying for it. We've got that in. That's been a submission because that whole thing needs to be upgraded, and we're doing some other things financially. Brubaker, and I do use his name, he's going to be busy over the next year, so this person could be on there depending on what vendors are in and out of that facility, because we got to pretty much cut out what we have over there. But we want to hopefully utilize the $300,000 worth of state and federal funds versus Gladwin money. We'd like to save our money for later on.
And then my other question was, because we talked about this in finance, but he had to dig these numbers up, was the 9 month, and we weren't sure if it was 9 or 6 or 7, and the 9 month was just my memory, which isn't always the best, but usually pretty close. So we need to confirm that it's 9 months or 6 months or 7 months that we used before.
Yeah, and it's just something that you do that. We will try, you know, I'm taking a guess at the $6,000 in overtime. That put an individual saving a substantial amount of money. We had an individual that was off for a couple of months. They were just off work for a while. and this individual manipulated the rest of the shifts around and then worked that shift Monday through Friday and did her own duties too. So, you know, I don't know what health things will come our way over there, but it's just something to keep in mind. I'm taking a stab at the $6,000 for that. Is there anything I'm missing on that, Ray? Do you remember? But, like I said, $161,000, if we can bank that over the next three-year period and we can get by, and it'll be tough, but everybody's doing more with less. So.
How soon do you need to know on this? Because I think we need Verushko to review the contractual thing that we have going on, and then we need to confirm the month range, what that is.
So it, I think, you know, it's kind of one of those, the sooner that we do it, the sooner we start saving money. But, you know, I'll leave it to you guys. You, as the Board of Commissioners, entered into an agreement with the supervisory group that there wouldn't be any more promotions into there. Now, there's a way for me to do it, but it's not, it's not going to be good contractually because we're going to lose some people. I can actually work somebody out of classification. But the moment I do that, it ties my hands because it gives me the inability to move them anywhere I went because of their own seniority. You know what I mean? Once we take them out of that group and we move them into the supervisory group, I can move them anywhere I want contractually, and it's not a violation of their collective bargaining agreement. It's all to do with that when we get around.
What's this individual's time frame for wanting?
I think you have to apply for retirement with MERS 90 days prior or something like that.
So we've got some time.
Yeah, well, I'd like to, at the very least, make it first of the year kind of thing. Well, what do we got? 4 months left in the year? Yeah, 4 months left.
What you need from us today is just a motion that we would, you know, look into this, or?
Yeah, I don't even need a motion or anything like that. I wanted you to evaluate it. If you can get back with me in 2 weeks after we've had the opportunity, if you guys want to chit-chat with Marushka, or whoever it is you'd like to chit-chat with. Really, it's just being synonymous with what you did for a potential other employee for the county for the health care for the spouse. I think that's the issue. Other than that, you've only got the issue with me promoting somebody that's currently a dispatcher into a little supervisory group, but they're going to do two jobs.
I just have a problem with the word buyout. So what we're doing is we're providing insurance for that person for 3 months or so after they leave.
Well, the one thing is you're going to notice that $5,461, that's a one-time cost up front, and it's over and done with. That's not a three-year reoccurring cost. The only thing that's a reoccurring cost on this is the difference in pay, the pay differential, to take somebody that's currently there and make them into supervisor. That's $1,700 a year, and then the overtime rate. But at the end of the day, if we're genuine wanting to save money, you know, there's not going to be a big lineup wanting to do what I'm doing here to save $161,000 because I'm losing a body, you know. And I'm hopeful to get along with it, but this has only got to work for about 3 months, and you're already back to zero in your buyout option, if you will. Like I said, I'll be happy to sit down with you at any time and kind of give you a rundown on it, but county has the opportunity to save $161,000 for the taxpayers when it comes to specific 911 funding.
I think we have talked to Bruce Gove and
sure. Well, I'd like to thank the sheriff. You know, I did sit in on the finance committee when this was coming about for the printout here. For those of you who are in on that thing, the only problem that I have, and I think that I should mention it, and Mike kind of referred to it back, was we did something similar to this with the animal control officer when he retired, and which I did not at that time think was a good idea. However, now we're being asked to do this again, and that's the problem I've got. It's not anything against what Mike has done, what he's trying to do, but when do we, you know, I mean, we're paying someone's insurance for 9 months ahead.
Can I respond to that, Terry?
Oh, certainly.
Anybody, any county employee that says, I'll give you $161,000 and it's going to cost you $5,000, by God, get them all lined up. You know?
But I
don't mean to be flippant about it, but I'm saying you're not going to get a big lineup that's going to save $161,000.
You're concerned, but I just want to let you know, I think we should be very careful with this myself. I mean, I'm not saying we should turn it down or accept it or what, but there's a trend here. When does it stop?
I remember there was two ladies that gave me some difficulty when we did that with animal control at one of the township meetings. And once I explained it, I think they were happy, but they weren't too happy at first.
Well, I could be off on my numbers once again slightly, but there was a yearly savings with animal control in the neighborhood of $45,000 a year. That's why we did it then. And I do think if we take some of these options like this and evaluate them, you know, with this one in particular, it's some contractual stuff we need to fix, and we need to find out the months works. Because whatever we did for the last employee certainly is what we'd want to do with this, so we don't get too far off kilter. But it is a cost savings. We'll evaluate it. We'll talk with Bruce, go. Terry and I'll try to get a recommendation back with you guys. Fair enough?
Thank you.
Thank you. Anything else from the board or the public?
Yes.
Yep.
I'm counting on and the one that's being sued over the month. Actually, I should agree with that. My wife's being sued. I'm doing some research here. I've heard we get plenty of complaints as to our actions with the plug bucket. Well, in all my digging, I found one. 4/6 of 2010. The next piece of evidence that comes into play to anything against me is an on-scene report from Deputy Goss. He performed a traffic stop in my driveway, arrested a guy for not having a driver's license who was on the road. Hey, that's his problem, not mine. This case picks up with a police report for something that had nothing to do with the actions on our property. Same place I'm finding all this. Due to the fact these bogs started when zoning was not in effect, therefore was allowed because it was an existing use. We've been having these bogs since 2000. Josh, you know, you've been coming out there. It's a waste of money. We're talking saving money. Listen to Mike. He's downsizing over there. It's money everywhere. You're spending money letting an attorney pick up a lawsuit that y'all knew nothing about. We come talk to the board. Your exact words, Josh, we know very little about this. So then, as we were asked to, we set up a memorandum of understanding, which got turned over to your guys' appointed board, the Planning Commission. We go there to deal with a lot of disrespect, which angers me dearly. It does. And I know you tried to address that, Josh. I don't think a memo was quite the way to go, but, you know, you said something. I'm going to give you that. You need to look at the facts. Facts are, we are doing nothing wrong. There's no criminal activity, ask the sheriff. One complaint on record Is that enough? I mean, we're watching county money go down a drain right here. Watching my money go down the drain. Watching my family go without because we have to stand up for this. For this. I have to take time from going to work to be here to address you. It's not fair to me. Definitely not fair to my family. So I'm going to ask one time. I've been quiet through this whole thing. You've all heard my leaseholders talk about patents, this, that, and the other thing. I'm not going to push that down your throat. What I am going to push down your throat is right here what's in your own files. This was ongoing before zoning was ever even thought of. Same property, never been moved. One complaint in 2010. We're in 2013, that's just fixed up over a police report, not a complaint.
Which documents were those? Were those from the...
From the zoning. From the zoning, right in the file, and you get them the same as I did.
There's
nothing from the sheriff's department.
No, no. Mike stated that he's had calls, they've been out there to check it out. Well, we've all heard his comments. He don't have the time, nor the money, nor the want.
You know, if I may, and I just a bit some pieces about what you're referring to, about my problem. Here's my take for what it's worth. We have a planning commission, we have a zoning board of appeals, and I'm sure you've been involved with all of them up to this point.
Yep.
And I would assume, maybe I should assume it, but there stands a good chance it'll probably be a lawsuit, or could be a lawsuit, or
whatever.
I'm just wondering what it is that we could do at this point. I mean, I'm not saying right, wrong, or otherwise, but there's two entities involved there that you should be dealing with or have dealt with, I guess, maybe
yes.
Not to your satisfaction. So I don't know, personally, what we as a board at this point could do.
Well, Mr. Whittington, I'd like to say that, you know, you guys are the commander-in-chiefs of our county. I mean, everybody reports here. Every concern comes here. Everything that happens in this county comes here. There's a lot you can do. You got a rogue drain commissioner out here making everybody mad. There's a lot you guys can do about that. I'm sorry, listening to you guys can't do nothing about it. Yes, you can. Start research. Research. Start looking into it. Everything through the county revolves around this board right here.
Well, if I may, and I'm certainly not here to argue with you, I'm just trying to understand. But in Mr. Evans' case with the drain commissioner, we're limited, very limited. So he is an elected official that's run that department. And whether we agree with him or whether we don't, I don't know how much jurisdiction we actually have over that department. So
I've done a considerable amount of research, and we have pretty much zero. But the way we're trying to handle it right now, communication, working with the state, you know, I don't see any other way. I just don't. And I've been asking, we've got Joel Johnson working on it. Michigan Association of Counties knows it's an issue for us. We're reaching out like anybody else would in our situation. I don't know what else to do.
Well, I understand that, you know, and I mean, yeah, you guys are looking into it, but the money that is getting spent on lawsuits, search warrants. Jess, you have a big party. How would you like cops come in there and serve a search warrant?
No,
I'm just saying, put yourself in my shoes. You know, this has been ongoing since before zoning. And now all of a sudden, it's getting picked up again with no complaint. No complaint. None.
I
don't understand it. How can the attorney that you guys appoint over the county for us the people and pay him can pick up a lawsuit just like that? Nobody knows. Nobody has an answer for that. And right there's your solution to my problem. Fire Jacobson. Fire the attorney. Start looking elsewhere. He's costing money. We have the proof.
May I ask where do you stand now with the committees that you've been dealing with? I mean, the Planning Commission, the Board of Appeals.
I'm still sitting in the same place we were to begin with. We've got a new attorney on it that's involved now. It's been postponed till the 5th. There will be another settlement conference, which I will say on the record and to all of you, I will not settle. I'm not going to spend 900 and some dollars for permits. And the same stuff right here, because people have camped on my property. Now it's campground recreation, outdoor amusement park. I mean, when did down home on the farm fun get labeled as a camping recreation area? When did it get labeled as an outdoor amusement park? You know, this is stuff that's been going on long with you guys were kids. You know, Josh has been to my place numerous times. I know that. I have nothing to hide. We don't charge. We do a donation once in a while to help somebody in the community that needs it. Times are tough all over, you know? You guys are cutting budgets. I'm cutting budget in my house to be here right now. You know, my kids are going without the fun they normally have in the summer because guess what? I'm at board meetings. I'm at attorney meetings. I'm at planning commission meetings. And I'm sorry, as far as the planning commission goes, that's a joke. We don't need it. I mean, there's bigger cities in the world that don't have planning and zoning, and they're doing just fine. We're just a rural county.
If I may, and I'm not up on the litigation part of it, but where do we stand at this point? I mean, is it? I know you got your side, and my planning commission or whatever.
We're in for September 5th, I believe at 9 o'clock in the morning, for another pre-trial now because of the new attorney.
Is it a settlement, though?
It's a settlement, too, plus a few motion hearings to go along with it. You know, I'm not going to settle. I'll let you all know that right now. The only way that I settle is if it just gets dismissed, never to be brought up again. I mean, it's getting carried away. It has. The taxpayers, I mean, and me included, I pay my taxes. As a taxpayer, I'm sickened by this. But I have to pay for this. You know, and then to hear, now that this is going on, I got a lot of people that do come to me with stuff. And say, hey, yeah, this is what happened to me. You know, and my township, Gladwin Township, pays the county for zoning, $3,500 a year. Which I'm in the process of trying to work with my township to get them to do away with. Let's save the money. You know, I wish Commissioner Carl was here, you know, shed some light.
Well, you bring up a point, as far as your township goes, they do have an option.
Yes.
Should the majority of them decide they'd rather have their own zoning.
And our township has found out over the last, they're kind of iffy waiting on this whole ordeal. But there's a lot of other people that are very unhappy with the county zoning and the actions that they have taken. Everything comes out in the wash. You know, everybody's coming to me because they know, hey, this guy's standing up. You know, everybody's scared. You know, we need to make it to where it's more people want to live here instead of move away from here. How many times do you guys hear in a week that somebody wants to move out of here? There's nothing here. I hear it a lot. I know a lot of people that have moved away. I know a lot of people that they're seeing this. They're like, man, I am so glad I don't live there. It was my understanding that Mr. Dunn gave you guys a resolution on property rights. Anybody sign that, just out of curiosity?
It would have to be adopted by the board.
Oh, well, okay. That's the last thing we have in the world is our property. You know, we can't let the government control every little thing. Can't. That's un-American. Unconstitutional.
Well, you raised a good point, and some of it is the townships choose to have us do their job.
Right.
The zoning thing. So, I mean, we need to evaluate all that. I'm sure all the townships are going to be looking at that. We're certainly open-minded to all of it. We don't necessarily like to be in this situation at all.
Oh, I'm sure you don't.
We don't want to be in this situation, but we're here, you know, and at this point, I don't know that there's necessarily hard feelings either way. We need to sort it out. It just has to get sorted out. It looks like that's going to go through the court process. You know, my hopes were that, you know, we could come up with a few things and agreements as far as keeping the cars off the road and having outhouses out there and some of that stuff.
And that stuff's all been addressed.
Right, and then that went, and I know you guys have done that to the point, but they did go to the Planning Commission, and I saw the video to that, and that was relatively unsuccessful. But currently, that's the way we're structured. We're open-minded enough to evaluate all of this as we're moving on, but currently, the way we're structured, it leaves us with very little options here with this board. But,
you know, I from day one, it's not going to help your situation. I have never been a believer in county zoning, even when it was put into effect. Because I was a township supervisor years and years ago, and at that time we created our own zoning because we were not happy. I guess that could be the next step that your township could take.
Right, that's what we're looking into that way. Which is going to kind of hurt you guys on the budget plan a little bit.
Not really. I mean, this costs us money.
right.
Technically do this, and, you know, it goes back to everybody working together. And all right, so if the county of Gladman does it, we can hire one person, and this should be okay. But then everybody has their own idea about what they want. So you have a zoning ordinance that just
gets... I believe the zoning should be
at the township level.
It really should. You know, I mean, that's where... Everybody should go. In all honesty, you know, a lot of townships around here don't even want zoning. I mean, you got areas like Sugar Springs, Sage Township, you know, Sage Township's up. I lived there for a while. They love their zoning over there. They do.
And what applies to one township may not necessarily apply to another.
Exactly. You know, and you know, I understand that, you know, certain communities want it a certain way. Is certain townships, you know, in communities, you know, and, you know, none of the one complaint, which is there, from the neighbor, he also addressed the Planning Commission, right along with another neighbor, that just for the record, both of them have come to me and apologized. Both of them said the same, right? Said, you know, you do have the right to enjoy your property as you see fit. No, it ain't every weekend. You know, it's scattered out. You know, they see now, they've seen the videos, they've seen the excuse the language, but the hell I've been through. You know, and the toll it's taken on my family and my marriage. You know, I mean, my wife gets mad because I'm researching 24/7. I got people calling me in the middle of the night, hey, check this out. Hey, can you help me with this? You know? And I'm not the guy to turn anybody or any option away.
Can you have those individuals go to the Planning Commission and express their sorrow? You know, at the end of the day,
but both of them were pretty adamant on how mad at the Planning Commission they were. They seen the disrespect too, you know? I'm pleased to see you guys ain't wearing your hats and stuff while you're having meetings, and, you know, you guys ain't yelling at the public, you know, and I appreciate that. I didn't appreciate it from the Planning Commission, you know, and that all resides with you guys. That is a board that is appointed by you guys.
Well, we have mud boggers up in Millings Township.
Yes, you do.
So, I mean, it's nothing personal, it's just...
Right.
Right.
And see, that's, Billings is another township. You hear a lot of bad reports of on the zoning issues and stuff. But you go down to Billings Township, start asking around about Mudbog. There's three of them down there. Everybody knows where all three of them are. And not one person, no matter what the age, has any problem with it. You know, and another way to look at this is if you go through and we shut down all these backyard bogs, guys like Joe Myers, Jim at Napa, Bob at CarQuest, them guys take a big hurt. They do. I quit in 2010. I quit having the Easter bug. It was not because of the complaint or nothing like that. It was a headache. It was. It was stressful. It wasn't fun no more. So we quit having the large numbered events. You know, since then, there hasn't been no complaints. You know, the hotels down in the Shoe, and even here in town, got a hold of me in 2011, 2012. Why ain't you having the Easter weekend? We counted on that money. Just too much of a headache. You know? I mean, you look at Hale. I went up there this weekend for Trucks Gone Wild, that's what it's called. It was fun to a point. I would have liked it better if I could have had my kids around and had them enjoy some of the show that I got to see. But that was not a family-friendly event. That was well over, I'm going to say right around 20,000 people. And that was across of Mardi Gras, Girls Gone Wild, and everything else. That was definitely not a family event, you know? And that's what we're keeping with our place, is the family-oriented event. You know, and that's what Gladwin County is. It's rural, down home, fun. You know, nobody's getting hurt. Nothing bad's going on. The local bug community raised over $4,000 for the Gladwin County Fairgrounds, which was more than any other event that the fairgrounds had in the grandstand. You know, we pull together. The bug community is a big family, especially around Gladwin.
And I'm still trying to find a seal for my gator. Yeah. They apparently don't
make a play. Right?
Right.
You know, parts ain't flying, you ain't trying. You know, so I just ask the board to really evaluate our county attorney at this point. Where this goes is where it's going to go. We're in. I'm in it for the long haul. You all know where I stand on that. But where I stand as a taxpayer to see a county attorney taking on authority of his own without the permission of the commander-in-chief, the board, is pretty sickening. And I hope you guys look into it. You know, it's not the only attorney out there. This town's full of them.
We know, you know, we just paid a bunch of them.
So, thank you for your time.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Can I
have sure. Can you state the name for the record?
This is, I'm Lorraine Gunderson. Okay. I do not know the Millers. This is the first time I've ever seen them. But I am a victim of mud bogging. My neighbor has bolt has forced my borders twice to get to the water on my land. He bulldozed more than 9,000 square feet of my land. And then after he was finished, he put a fraudulent survey around the area that he took and used survey caps that don't even belong to anybody in this county. I had to pay $1,500 to get a survey for one corner to prove that was my land. I had to pay for a forester report, and I could get no help from the authorities. I talked to the Attorney General's office, and he told me every tree that was stolen was a crime. Every tree. No crimes have been processed at all. I am spending all of my money, and I stand alone.
against a mob of people that are trying to force this to happen, that there's no win-win happening here. You have to think of me too. You can't take my land. You can't make my life miserable. You can't rumble my windows for hours where I have no place to hide. You can't attack my waterway that I share with all the citizens of the world, of the United, of Michigan. You can't bulldoze my borders and force me to accept mudblocking. You just can't do it. And then intimidate me because I don't accept it. I accept, and the other thing is people aren't just leaving because their rights are being taken away. They're also leaving because they don't want to hear that crap. If I could sell my place, I would meet leave. The drain commissioner has rendered probably a 120-foot long ditch, 420 feet long on my property. At the same time, my neighbor was bulldozing my trees and I couldn't get any help. That's why people are leaving Gladwin. There's got to be a win-win. I'm here too. I'm not as big as the mob of mudboggers, but I'm here too, and that was my land, and I'm standing here to protect it. And that's all I have to say.
Thank you. And Lorraine, I did speak about a couple of your issues with the board earlier.
I got to put my heart rate back down.
Is there anything else from the public? Anything from the board? Motion to receive and file.
I'll make that motion.
It's been moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.
Move to my turn.
I'll support that. It's been moved and supported. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Thank you all for attending. If you need anything, call us.